Fallout 4 is a game rated M by the ESRB. Hello and welcome back to more Steven Plays Fallout 4. On the last episode, we finally finished up the USS Constitution, which is very exciting. It took several episodes, but honestly, I think it was one of my favorite quests so far. Very unique, very different, very quirky. Today, I'm going to start out by equipping the Broadsider. I went ahead and upgraded this as far as it could. There wasn't a whole lot of stuff you could do to it. You can make the barrel lighter. You could increase the grip. And then you could increase the firing rate by, I guess, it holds a few cannonballs. So it's by no means our best gun. I think the last minute has that beat by a mile. 282 damage versus 164 damage. But you still get to fire cannonballs at someone. And that's pretty exciting. The reason I'm over here by the Cabot House is that today we're going to start with setting up another one of those MILA things for the railroad. And it's at an undiscovered location. Now, if these things take place at a place we've been, I may just cut it out. Maybe just start an episode, you know, setting it up so I've done all the other stuff. But because we've never been to this location, I think that we should show it. So that's what we're going to start with today. And then go from there. I have a few other things that you guys suggested that we'll take care of. Oh, and one final thing. Because so many people asked about this. The lieutenant's hat cannot be modded with the ballistic sweep. I'm sorry. There are so many people that wanted that to happen, and unfortunately, that's just not the okay. Don't look, but I think they're being watched. Let's try this thing out, shall we? Holy crap! Oh my god! Did I just like not? Did I just break that guy's legs off? I think so. That's pretty sweet. Okay, so I can put, because of this thing, I can put like three in here. Okay, there's something crazy over there. I don't know what's going on. Miss that guy. Didn't miss him that time. Hey, buddy. This is a fun weapon. I should use it in VATS and see how it differs. Can I hit that guy? Can I blow that guy's head off with this? Boom! Okay, no, I didn't. It's upsetting. You don't have very many of these. I'm not really sure where you get more cannonballs. It's not really an ammo type that I've seen much of. I'm gonna hit this guy. Hey, don't you run from me. One of these is gonna hit you. Oh, it killed him! Even though it didn't set, it said it wouldn't, but then it, like, totally did. Like, they just explode. There must be some, like, additional damage or something that's going on. There's a Rust Devil Center Dot. There's a friendly Mr. Handy, which is odd. Oh, God. I don't know, what type of weapon is that? Sentry Bot Carnage. Okay, I don't know, but I'm not a big fan. Also, it has full health somehow? Oh god. Okay, we're gonna have to not hold on to the Broadsider because it's weighing us down. Jesus. Deacon, what the crap is this thing? Sentry Bot Carnage. I mean, as you advance in the game, like, you're gonna fight new and different types of enemies. This must be just a variation of the normal sentry bot that you fight once you get to a certain level. I don't know what weapon that is, but it's crazy. At least crazy looking. I don't know if it's actually doing much to me. Plasma Wisp? Okay, let's aim for the head. Crit! Oh, not much damage. Did it stumble a little? Stumbled a little. I mean, it's a sentry bot. We're playing them very hard, and it's a sentry bot. I don't know what we expected. There's someone else shooting at me. Doggone it, dude. I don't have time for your bullcrap. Just die already. Your head exploded into goo, which is exactly the fate you deserved. Okay, this actually does work pretty well. You're done. Okay, this should explode. Gracious sakes. Well, it's been 4 minutes, but now we can finally, like, move out of this area. The Broadsider is cool. It doesn't work so well on robots, but on people, even though it says it's not going to do a whole lot of damage, sometimes they just, like, explode, which is pretty awesome. Pretty big fan of that. There was a legendary somewhere. I'm going to give Deacon.
Hey.
Sure. I can help you out.
Let's see what I got in my pockets.
I'm going to go ahead and let him hold on to the broadsider. I just wanted to show it off. We used about half the ammo. It's a pretty interesting thing. Maybe later in the game we'll play with it some more. But I want to hold on to it because it's pretty friggin' heavy. I think it's almost 30 pounds, which is a lot of pounds. Sultron Devil, a mini nuke. Which one of you had the... there were two sentry bots? I think there was a friendly Mr. Okay, quick draw switchblade. That's not that interesting. And then another one of these guys. Fascinating. Truly fascinating. Alright, we'll continue forward. We've already got in one kerfuffle. Boston Bugle Building, which I believe is where we're supposed to be going. This is where we've got to install the Myla. This is definitely where I expected to find some enemies. Oh. My game, like, froze briefly. Interesting mass fusion. I mean, we're in downtown, and there's a lot of stuff just densely packed down here. What is that sign? Oh, it's Good Neighbor. Oh, okay. Well, at least I have an idea of where I am. Huh. Alright, let's, switch back over to Nasty Nancy for a bit. Just kind of getting a rundown of the area. I've been in here before, the old corner bookstore. So I've been in this area. It's interesting how, like, just one block over, I had not been in the, I had not seen this area, had not seen the Mass Fusion building or whatever. Alright, so, we're in the right spot. We gotta go in up the Boston Bugle because apparently on the roof is where we have to install this satellite thing. Is it? Let me just double check. The Boston Bugle. Okay. Tinker Tom wants me to place, Myla, a combination surveillance device, okay. Alright, this is where we gotta go. Let's do it. Alright. Okay. Let's keep moving around. Someone's gonna be here. Just have to figure out who. Now, I understand that there's a lot of these, Myla, or Mila, or whatever, quests. But we are gonna get them done eventually. Gonna try and spread them out, but I would like to focus on some railroad stuff, because there were some people in the comments saying, and this makes sense, if we do some stuff for the railroad,
I don't know if even a scaver would take that.
Deacon will probably like us faster, even though he really doesn't like it when we pick up clipboards for whatever reason. Oh, I don't think I've ever seen one on the wall that was blown up. That's interesting. So if we're trying to get Deacon's affinity more quickly, then we should maybe focus on some railroad stuff. Although my primary objective is clear out my ridiculously big list of missions. Not getting on board? Whatever, dude. Going up. Which door opens?
Unidentified intruder.
Oh god. No, 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 no. Oh, you fell down. Sorry about that, pal. So this door doesn't actually open. Boston Bugle. So this is one of the newspapers. Doesn't seem like there's anyone down there. And the hidden's actually not moving, so I think it might be good to stand up. Typewriter, sure. Still grabbing some scrap here and there. Typewriter again. That's a lot of typewriters. Vault Tech Lunchbox! Bubblegum, yay! It's gotta let me know every time I even possibly pick up one of these, lunchboxes. Anything in there? Ooh, what's on display today? Moldy food! Mm-hmm. Yeah, honestly, most of the time I feel like I've eaten moldy food in real life. I'm always stinking sick. Alright, let's try care. I was hoping it would care to let me in. How about, it can't be free, it could be join. It is join. Trumpeting truth for over 50 years. Front page news, blah blah blah, article 1, let's just read through these articles. Case closed on crime boss Eddie Winter. In a move that has shocked and angered the people of Massachusetts, the Boston Police Department announced last night that they have ceased all investigations into the actions of reputed organized crime boss Edward Eddie Winter. Speaking on behalf of the special task force that had been assembled specifically to build a case against Winter, Captain Jonathan Widmark of the BPD said, "After reviewing the evidence with our colleagues at the Bureau of Alcohol, Drugs, Tobacco, Firearms, and Lasers, it became clear that we were, in fact, wrong. Eddie Winter has indeed had a colorful history, but it is not a criminal history. By pursuing our case against Mr. Winter, we would simply continue to waste taxpayer dollars and, even worse, condemn an innocent man." It was an unexpected turn of events, to be sure. According to the Boston Bugle's confidential sources within the Boston Police Department, the innocent man was anything but. As uncovered by Captain Widmark's official investigation, codenamed Operation Winter's End, Eddie Winter was involved in every crime imaginable, from petty larceny to first-degree murder. And although nothing was proved, everyone on Widmark's task force suspected Winter in the August homicide death of their lead detective's fiancée, a Miss Jennifer Lance. Whatever the truth, it would appear the city of Boston had nothing more to fear from, or has nothing more to fear from Eddie Winter. When approached for comment, the alleged crime boss could not be reached. In fact, his South Boston sub shop has been shuttered and his Harborside residence completely cleaned out. Eddie Winter, it would seem, has disappeared. That's a little interesting to me, just because we have picked up, and it's been a long time, so I'm pulling from my brain here. We picked up some holotapes at various places about Eddie Winter. So he was this crime boss, allegedly, and I guess we'll learn more about him later on. Article 2. China Showdown, the Atomic Ultimatum, War. Has there been any extended period of time in recent memory in which soldiers have not fought, bled, and died, all for the sake of furthering the political goals of one government or another? The short answer is no. The longer, more terrifying answer is that we have not yet begun to experience the extent of human suffering. From Anchorage in frigid Alaska to Shantou on our enemy's doorstep, American troops have been embroiled in brutal battle. They have taken and lost many lives, a nearly uncountable number, but not entirely. Because the truth is, the casualties have been countable. These conflicts, however horrible, have all been, in some inexplicable, perverted way, manageable. Through taxes and various wartime revenues, the United States government has been able to fund a standing army the likes of which this country has never before seen. The same is certainly true of our mortal foe, China. And with each dollar spent comes a natural accounting of how that dollar was spent. Every bullet, every bunker-busting bomb, every body bag. Soon after each is used in the theater of war, we know every how, when, and where. But the sad obvious truth is that the days of manageable war have nearly come to an end. In the minds of the world's great leaders, those billions of dollars haven't merely been spent, they've been wasted. Because here we are after more than a decade of constant warfare with no clear end, and no clear winner in sight. So really, at this point, what other option do these superpowers have if not the nuclear one? And therein, of course, lies the rub. For when China or the US launches its nuclear missiles and drops its atomic bombs, there will be no one left to count the casualties, let alone the ordnance. No one left to declare victory. So then only one question remains. Is there any way the powers of the world can prevent a nuclear apocalypse? If there is any hope left for the world, we must believe the answer is yes. But these are hopeless times. That's sad, and also, I've talked about it before, but like Fallout has a grounds in reality. There's obviously some elements of the game that are outside of reality, but a lot of it is implanted, you know, into reality, and it's disturbing to read things like that because we all know what happened. There was an apocalypse. It's a little frightening. Boston food riots continued. In what can only be described as a scene of absolute pandemonium, on Friday afternoon, soldiers of the United States Army's 184th Infantry Regiment opened fire on a group of unarmed civilians after an unknown person smashed the plate glass window of the Roxbury Food Bank, prompting several people in the line outside to storm into the establishment. As of yesterday evening, at least four people were confirmed dead and eight others injured, but Jonathan Corman, spokesman for the Army, insists the troops acted within their authority. The soldiers in question issued explicit verbal warnings several times. Those people knew exactly what would happen if they broke the line and attacked the food bank. Hunger is no excuse for civil disobedience, vandalism, or in this case, starting a riot that puts the lives of every civilian in the area at risk. It is the role of the United States Army to maintain order in this difficult time, and that is exactly what happened in this instance. I would also like to point out that the soldiers of the 184th Infantry Regiment have not had a food ration in 2 days. These men and women understand hunger probably better than anyone. It is a response the American people have grown accustomed to, as violent scenes like the one in Roxbury have played out again and again across the country as a starving populace tries desperately to obtain food for its families. And, as has happened so many times in the past, the civilian witnesses of the so-called riot tell a different tale. 85-year-old grandmother Hannah Henry was in line at the food bank and claims the soldiers had anything but order and liberty on their minds. They were laughing, joking about who they were going to shoot first. It was all a game to them. Those soldiers may not have fired on the crowd before that window got broke, but they was looking forward to it all the same. One can only hope that the violence in Roxbury will be the last such incident our country has to suffer through. But until America finds the strength to question its domestic policies and the food to feed its people, the future remains uncertain. Article 4. White House remains empty. Where's our president? For more than half a year, the West Wing of America's most famous residence has remained shrouded in near-complete darkness. A skeleton crew of manual laborers remains on staff to maintain the property, but nobody has lived or worked politically there for several months. And even though the White House press corps was unofficially and unceremoniously disbanded around the same time, the media has remained steadfast in answering that most important of questions. Where is our president? At first, the assumption was that the entirety of the United States government had moved operations to Raven Rock, the military operations center located in the mountainous region of Pennsylvania, just a few miles northeast of the presidential retreat in Camp David, Maryland. But further investigations have revealed that neither the president nor his cabinet have been to the Raven Rock complex in over a year. So if not Raven Rock, then where? Thanks to an extensive and exhaustive investigation, the Boston Bugle has uncovered the answer, and our readers will likely consider it as strange as it is shocking. The president has been leading our country from a Poseidon Energy oil rig just off the coast of San Francisco. It's certainly an odd choice for a presidential command center. Or is it? Not as much as it may seem, as our investigation discovered. Thanks to the testimony of a highly placed anonymous source, the Boston Bugle has learned that the official designation of the oil rig is actually Control Station Enclave, giving credence to the long-running rumors of a secret militarized shadow government known as the Enclave that would take control of the United States in the event of a nuclear conflagration. Or conflagration. And so, the mystery of the missing president has finally been solved. But in doing so, has the Boston Bugle also uncovered evidence that the end of the world, in the form of total atomic war, is also at hand? Sadly, the president's silence seems to speak volumes. And finally, the last article. Boston headed for first World Series win since 1918. As every resident of Boston is painfully aware, it has been 159 years since the city has reveled in the joy of a World Series victory, whether from strikeout, error in the outfield, or ball that rolls disastrously through an infielder's legs, defeat has remained our constant unwelcome companion. But not for long. In what has been one of the most exciting World Series races in decades, Boston has achieved a 3-0 lead over the unbeatable Texas favorite. Batting, fielding, and pitching have all aligned, thanks largely to the direction of legendary coach Dusty Wilder, giving this year's team the best chance they've had for victory in, well, forever. Even more encouraging than Game 4 being played here in Boston is the fact that the team has yet to utilize their star pitcher, Matt the Missile Murtaugh. With him on the mound, some are actually predicting not only a series-shattering win, but a no-hitter to boot. Yes, for years, the concession stands of Boston have fed baseball fans a steady diet of beer, hot dogs, peanuts, and bitter defeat. But on Saturday, October 3rd, 2077, the only thing that could snatch away victory is an act of God, or some obscene calamity of man. Tomorrow, my friends, the unthinkable will finally come to pass, and life in Boston will never be the same again. That's a funny article. Well, that was fun. Everyone who... What? Oh, it's from cracking it. I thought Deacon likes it when you read. Deacon is secretly a librarian. So for everyone else who, you know, skipped ahead, hi, welcome back. Let's proceed. It was a bunch of news articles. I found it very interesting. Maybe you will as well, but if not, that's cool. Let's move on. What we got here? Does this take us downstairs? We ultimately need to be going up. Because we got to get to the roof. But I want to look around while I'm here, so let's take a peeky-poo. That's cute. You're good to go. Freddy Fear's House of Scares. This is just a pile of crap. Maybe not entirely crap. There's the thing we killed. Oh, hey, a trunk. That was pretty sweet. Yeah, I'll take that. And we've got... I have a feeling... I gotta crack this because it's gonna give me stuff. I'm really fond of terminals. Put a cork in it. Aw, oh, dang it. Really? O-R? She tore into me. What? Down one? I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it's probably lock, because it was probably the O and the K from cork that made it work.
Sweet.
There we go. And these are all the same, I bet you anything. They are... Yes, they're the same. Okay. So there's no more lore. For everyone who was suddenly worried, like, no! There's not. This place is really destroyed, and I was actually expecting kind of like something to actually see. There's really nothing, from what I can tell, nothing down here. I think the lore is interesting, but that's, from what I can see, the only thing in here. That's it. Nothing else. Nuka-Cola bottles. I mean, this elevator takes you to a room where you can read those articles, and then otherwise, I'm assuming we have roof access. And we do. And I hear some shooting. Oh man, someone actually were- oh. For a minute I was like, someone worked outside, and I realized actually it's just part of the, part of the thing has been blown off. I'm gonna take those, that's what Kellogg smoked, actually. That's why we're here. That takes care of, Milo. We gotta report back to Tinker Tom. And then there's a safe here, which we should probably go ahead and take care of as well. There we are.
Sweet.
Ammo, fancy, God for sure. Sell, round, money, shells. Cool. And Deacon like that? That's what Deacon likes everything. We're in good shape with oh, hey, buddy. Be careful with that thing, because I'm gonna be honest, I don't think I have seen a single plane that has, like, not crashed into something. I'm not saying you guys are bad drivers. But, like, you are legitimately bad drivers. Oh, you can actually, like, you can target the vertibird, and it really doesn't have that much health. I mean, that we're technically on the same team, so I'm not gonna shoot it down, but it's good to know. Can I fast travel from here? Let me see if it'll let me. Yeah, it's gonna let me. Okay, let's go report this back to Tinker Tom.
The latest atmospheric reading from the new Mila is still inconclusive, but we'll catch the Institute. Could always use more Milas placed, if you're interested.
Oh, you just give me another one?
But if you're here to check out the latest and greatest, that's good.
Anything new from Mila?
Ooh, Pam's like a glowing one in a crater, soaking up all the data from Mila's cameras. The atmospheric sensors haven't picked up anything yet, but give it time.
I gotta go.
Right you are.
Alright, so that takes care of another one. Once again, there are 12 of those. We've done a handful at this point, which is nice. So, we didn't really get rid of anything on the quest list, we just exchanged it for a new one. But the next thing we're gonna do is actually gonna get rid of something. I had a few people request the Gilded Grasshopper. Nick's former partner, Marty Bullfinch, believes there's a treasure map hidden in the Gilded Grasshopper on top of Faneuil Hall. I should pay the hall a visit. Also, we've been by that hall like a million times, we've never actually gone in. The place is overrun with super mutants, so it's going to be a heck of a battle, but I think it would be fun to take care of. Also, I want to acknowledge this on video because I've had so many people asking. So many people have asked to go to Vault 81. I want you to know, I hear you. I have it written down on my notes. I know a lot of people want me to see me go there. I just want to point out, we have a huge list. I'd like this list to go away mostly. I don't want to keep adding new stuff to the list. I want the list to go away. So, Vault 81, heard. We will take care of it. But for now, let's take care of some of the stuff that we have on this list. It's a long game. We're going to be playing a while. The Gilded Grasshopper is over at Faneuil Hall. Yeah, we can warp there. And I have a feeling when we do, we're probably going to be in a firefight. But what the heck? Let's do it. Okay. Faneuil Hall. And no enemies, which is peculiar. One of the vertibirds is still around. Not locking onto anything. Are there seriously no super mutants around? I mean, that's a little confusing, but God, I gotta admit, I'm really excited about it. Okay. We gotta go in this place. Super mutants, gonna get shot up bad. What gun should I take in here? I have a lot of ammo for this. I think I'm gonna use this for now. Let's do it! Okay. What do we got?
Did you make that noise? Sorry. A little jumpy.
Don't do that. Come on, I'm jumpy as well. Got a little friend here who could probably help us out. If nothing else, we should hack it just for the experience. Don't deny me this, robot! Ah, shoot. Okay, something completely different then. How about... No, it can't be runs. How about ties? Oh, God, it's not ties either. Okay, could it be roll? Okay? That's weird. There must be something very obvious I'm missing. Can't be sewn. Could it be... It could be slip.
There we go.
Alright. Protectron control. Personality mode. Let's do... Yeah, let's do construction worker. I really like doing construction worker. Because anything that has to do with hard hats makes Grit Jones very excited. Activate units.
Terminals. It's like the old world flipping us off all over again. Seems we have a
what's up, bro? Yeah, you dead? Who else wants some of this? Legendary Super Mutant Butcher. Oh god, that's a big one. But I can take him. Deacon! No! Deacon! God, how many of them are there? You want some of this, buddy? Oh god. Reload, reload, reload. Going into badass Jones mode over here. Oh, shoot. Boom! It was a bad shot. Got you there. Alright, things are going fine. Things are going okay. Work on the legendary. Things are good, things are good. Thought I had Molotov cocktails equipped, but I don't, and I have a ton of them, and I would like to use some of them up, so let's equip those sons of guns. Enraging Hardened Combat Sniper Rifle. Critical hits cause targets to frenzy. Huh. That's kind of a neat thing. I don't know if I've seen that before. Frag grenade. You guys normally have some interesting things like that. Not always, but occasionally. Charging sniper, let's unlock this. There's gonna be a lot of super mutants in here, but based on this first room, I'm really not concerned.
Yes.
I'm really not. I think we're gonna be fine. Bourbon. I'm good. I think that's the last thing I need right now. Pre-war money. Lots of pre-war money. Oh, in a safe. Wait, what building are we at? What is Faneuil Hall? I don't think we've been told what that is. Is that a college building of some sort? Maybe that will be made clear as we progress. Is there another magazine or anything over here? Okay, these guys are walking around. They will shoot us if they're around for too long, because we do have to be wearing hard hat. Neither of us are doing that. But it'll be all right. Take these cans. Disarming them, basically walking up and pressing A, gives you experience. There's really no reason not to do that. Duct tape. And that was never a way to go. Okay. Alright. We're good. Let's go ahead and power up. Did I ever shoot the... There was a bomb. I remember seeing it. Oh yeah, it blew up. Oh, are you after one? Good job, buddy. You're doing great. I'm gonna keep taking all this money. I'm trying to figure out what this building was. I hope that I figure that out. That's like something that's not even important, but it's important to me. There's a little drugstore in here. Something drugs. Can't really even tell what it says. If you want pre-war money, this is easily the place to get it. This is what you want. Also, did I see... Oh, it's a burnt grognak comic. It doesn't actually give me a real comic. Of course, there could be a comic in here somewhere. There's a lot of guys. More pre-war money. I think that this is single-handedly the most pre-war money I've ever seen in one spot. Like, easily. Oh, there's a visor. That's a funny... I think I probably have one, but it's still a funny item. You can go downstairs. It's just a lot of stuff. Oh, that robot stepped on that. That's where the sound came from. Alright. Ring stand. Kitchen scale. Sure. Disarm this stuff. Apparently I'm in danger. I disagree. I don't think I'm in danger at all. As long as there's not a, this is the front door. As long as there's not a suicider, I do not think I'm in danger whatsoever. Okay. Let's just check out the rooms back here. Are there any traps or anything here? This is where they slept. Okay, I got the key. I don't know what the key is going to do, but there's a key. There's also a manager's terminal, which may explain what this stupid building is. Marketplace reports. Okay, let's check out this. Weekly sale. Okay, so it's some sort of marketplace. Weekly sales down 3% relative to last year. Merchants meeting focused on shoplifting crisis. Discuss Fallon's proposal for Protectrons and society objections to it. Society issued veto on historic preservation grounds. That's interesting. All merchants agreed to detailed inventory tracking to assess scope of the problem. Weekly sales up 11% due to Columbus Day holiday. Merchants inventory report showed net losses of $22.94 for the week. Okay, and then this. Weekly sales down 81% due to press coverage of the incident. 7 deaths reported due to altercations with Protectrons. Oh my god, that's funny. So they were like, maybe we should get these Protectrons, and they got them, and then they killed everyone. Freedom Society minutes. September. Meeting called to order. Jay Winthrop presiding. Read minutes of August meeting. Minutes approved. 14-0. Motion to amend the Society Charter. Consider merchant's proposal for Protectrons to secure the Faneuil Hall Marketplace. Objection raised on historic ground. Motion failed. Motion to file suit against new owners. Blah, blah, blah. Meeting adjourned. And then the October meeting. Called to order. Blah, blah, blah. Legal action against Old Corner Bookstore. Mayor insists that Protectron installation will proceed despite objections. Okay, so the mayor's the one that did it. Well, that didn't work out very well, did it? Tour script. Established by Peter Faneuil in 1742, Faneuil Hall has been the civic heart of Boston for 3 centuries. The meeting hall has hosted speakers and debates from the first patriots to modern presidents, and Faneuil Marketplace is an oasis of commerce in the center of Boston's modern business district. Please take the time to explore the building and visit our merchants. Those of you with an interest in fine art may appreciate the gilded grasshopper, which can be seen on the weather vane atop the cupola. For those of you following the Freedom Trail, the next site on the trail will be Revere House in North End. Okay, Gilded Grasshopper. That's why we're here. There's also Protectron Control, but I think I released them all? Yeah, I think whenever you did one, it actually did all of them, so I don't have to worry about that. All of the enemies are above me. You know, get behind me, Satan. Get above me, mutant. You know how it is. There's a elevator here and broken stairs that reveal a spoon. Oh, happy day. It's exactly what I wanted from this adventure. But otherwise, we explored this area and we should be good. So the next logical step is to go upstairs and kill some dudes. The only thing I don't like about this gun, the only real problem I have with it is that the clip size is too small. I mean, this one's not much better, but you can fire rapidly with the Plasma Wisp. And it's just, it's too small. Of course, I guess Tesla's not much better. Sure yar. You in here? Oh, honey, no. Oh, maybe I could get someone working for me.
Stop! Human is friend.
You had a chance, you didn't take it. You could have been my friend, but you weren't. So I had to kill you. Camera?
Ammo isn't cheap. Can we just pay you to play dead?
Stop! Human is friend. Attack!
Alright, that's one on our team. Cool. Thanks for noticing that, Deacon. I don't think I ever would have caught that. That's one guy on our team. We'll keep walking around, see what we can find. Oh, God! I am troubled. Okay, stand up. No time for sneaking. Someone is mad. You guys are so mad.
Stop.
That's another one. Okay, you know what? I was going to pacify you, but no. You get to die. You work for me.
Super mutant. Kill everything.
Woo! Woo, 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 woo. I am on fire and stuff. Oh, good. That thing. Christ almighty.
Stop right
there.
That
one didn't work. Gonna have to go up and put a bullet in his... Is it a bullet? It's not really a bullet. You know what I mean. What up, friend? Oh! I didn't even get to you. How disappointing. Give me this. Is anyone else up here? Someone's up here. Who's up here? Hello? Oh, come on. Someone is around. What up, mutant hound? Oh, I had to reload. That was dumb. That thing's dead.
Stop right there.
Haha, you got pacified.
Kill.
Okay, cool. You're on my team. Okay, let's go ahead and reload this. Look around for a bit.
What? Who's there?
It's probably me. Got half the idiots in this building under my control. So that's helpful. Feels like there's someone on the other side of the stupid wall. Okay, let's keep looking around. Is there anything here, Mutant Hound Meat? That can be pretty helpful occasionally. You're never gonna help me because unfortunately you're up here and I need you downstairs. So you're gonna have to die. Sorry about that. It's just the way it is. You dead? You're not dead. Okay, now you're dead. Thank you. Was there anything up here? Oh, Deacon, you did it! Deacon, good job, buddy! Well, actually, also, probably... It's probably not just Deacon. It's probably also some of our guys that are working for us. And they will need to... They'll need to be disposed of as well. I'm gonna go ahead and give you some of this heavy stuff, Deacon. Oh, I still have the mods with me. That's probably one of the reasons I'm way down. Here, take all of this bullcrap that no one needs or wants. Thanks, buddy. You're the best. Turn this light back on so I can see if there is anything. Aha! Live and love.
Yes.
Companions permanently gain plus 10 health. Cool. Deacon, do you feel stronger? You should, because I just found a magazine. And that's how the world works now. Anything in here? No, just burnt stuff. I think they're... No, there is actually some we missed. So I'm not really sure what it's talking about. Honey, I'm home. Oh, God. What'd I step on? Kill him. Oh, God. Oh, God, there's two. Oh, got a little bit hasty there. Oh, I have to reload. Eat this, butthole. Sorry, Deacon. Takes care of that one. Deacon, you're going to be fine. You're gonna be fine. Legendary slow time has worn off. Woo! That was, I could have taken one. Taking two was, probably a little difficult. Don't worry, I shot his nuts off. Okay! A bottle cap, a single bottle cap, exactly what I wanted. Rounds. For a minute, I thought you were super mutant. Nothing in here. Wait, hold on. Got some drugs. Some ammo. A silver plate, oh boy! Anything else in here? Clock. Not really. There's a bunch of stuff just scattered around. But nothing of interest. Do those explode if you shoot them? That was a very important question, and the answer is yes. Yes, they do. And you know what? Now, I feel educated. No harm done. Alright, now we have to go upstairs, obviously, to get what we came here for, and I'm going to do that. Just gonna double check everything before I do, because, this is probably an area that we're simply not going to come back to. Especially if it's cleared out. There will be no reason to return. We got a magazine, I can't imagine them giving us two magazines, so I'm not really concerned that we missed anything like that. But there was a key. There was a key. So we need to figure out the human jaw. Oh boy, we got to figure out where that key goes to. How you doing, buddy? Just waiting for me to come back and do this. My God, it must be like shock treatment. Okay, you have anything? Do fusion cell. There's something that popped up. I think it was your gun. Has a long name, but is not that exciting. All right, are we good here? I'm gonna put this away because it's hindering my view of the screen. You died, you died. You were the human jaw guy. Let's just double check to see if there's anything else I'm missing. This was the ground floor, so there was definitely nothing down there. We walked in here, where I killed that guy. Huh, I think we actually might be good. Oh, wait. No, I missed this room. Okay, got the bobby pin. Got some toilets. Oh, we got a cap stash here. Which is not a lot, but it's something. Also means that we missed the other bathroom. That is a bomb. Let's fix that up. Is there something... Sometimes there's triggers and then there's explosives that are separate, but I think... Yeah, that was what I shot over here. That was the grenades. So even if I would have opened that, nothing bad would have happened. Then we went in here. Okay, let's head up further. Oh wait, how do you get up further? Oh, you gotta go in here, I think. Okay. Let's go upstairs and, I still don't know where the key was... You know, where the key went. Maybe that will be made... clear to me shortly? But it's not looking particularly promising. A little more ammo. That's a different door. But that doesn't go anywhere. Come over here, can't get anything out of that meat bag. This is where I fought the two guys that almost stunned me in. Got that guy. Alright. I think this place is pretty clear. I'm feeling pretty good about this. There was nothing in any of these places. Already got the magazine. Nothing around here. Maybe the key is just for upstairs? Maybe? I don't know. We found a key, but I don't know where it goes. Okay. Are there any enemies out here? I suppose not. Oh, Marty Bullfinch. Well, at least we know what happened to him. He did not make it. Got some shotgun shells, combat shotgun, battered fedora. Not gonna pick that up, I do have one already. What was your gun? Bayoneted calibrated, oh, I don't care. If it takes too long to say, it's probably not worth it anyway. Nothing over here. Gilded grasshopper.
Hell yeah.
Food for the grasshopper added. Okay. Read food for the grasshopper. Oh, it was the note inside. I see. Food for the grasshopper. Let's check this out. Shemdrown made it. May 25th, was that 1742? To my brethren and fellow grasshoppers, fell in ye year 1753-1755, November 13th, early in ye morning, by a great earthquake, by me old master above. Again, like to have met with utter ruin by fire, by hopping timely from my public station, came with a broken bones and much bruised. Cured and fixed. Old master's son Thomas drowned June 28th, 1768, and though I will promise to discharge my office, yet I shall vary as ye wind. On the banks of the Charles, where forever rests Master Shem, there one can find a life's worth. Hmm. On the banks of the Charles. Find Shem Drown's grave. That's still the thing we're on. That's still the thing we're on. We are here. Is it mark it where it is? No? Okay. It's on... Maybe they'll tell me in here. The note inside the Gilded Grasshopper seems to point towards Shem Drown's grave. Time to see what it still holds. Well, that's the thing. I don't actually know where that's pointing unless there's a marker I don't see. It said on the Charles, which I presume is the Charles River, but I'm not sure where the Charles River is. Huh. Well, we have to stop for today anyway, so maybe the comments can give me a useful hint in the direction I should be looking, and I'll try to figure it out from there. That is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Next episode, we'll finish up the Gilded Grasshopper, and then we'll get started on some more miscellaneous stuff. Tell me what you want to see. We've got quite a few things that we can still do. Point me in the direction. We'll take care of it. The miscellaneous stuff I'm less concerned with, just because there's so much of it and it's all down here. I really want to just clean up this list, so pick one of these, we'll work on that, and try to tidy this up while also gaining affinity with Deacon. Thanks for watching, see you next time for more Steven Plays Fallout 4.
Attack!
Okay, what... where did that come from? Why did you say that?